So I'm very, very happy that we have the possibility to meet and to talk today here. Mm-hmm. And especially after this intense weekend we had with you, Pamela Ferguson. In the beginning, I would like to introduce you shortly. I would mm-hmm. love to start with you, Edith Storch, mm-hmm. my teacher at the Shiatsu Zentrum. And I think this is a great chance also to say thank you for you. Thank you, Edith Storch, yes. because you teach me so many things, not only in Shiatsu, mm-hmm. also for life. And the last years were very intense for me to be at your Zentrum.
Wow, yeah. Thank you very much, Katrin.
Mm-hmm. And as I heard that you start in the 80s with Shiatsu.
Right, right, that's right.
Mm-hmm. In the beginning of 1980. Mm-hmm. And then you practiced and teached already. And mm-hmm. you opened your school in 1991, mm-hmm. the Shiatsu school. Mm-hmm. And now we have 2011. So it's the 20th anniversary, yes. uh-huh. isn't it?
Yeah,
so
yeah exactly.
20 years Shiatsu Zentrum. Mm-hmm. Berlin, mm-hmm. in the Oranienstraße. So, congratulations.
yes. mm-hmm. Thank you.
That's great. Uh-huh. And now I would love to introduce Pamela Ferguson from Texas. And she's coming every year to the Shiatsu Zentrum Edith Storch and is teaching there, and she is a very experienced teacher. And you get invited by in Zurich and Vienna and also Switzerland, Austria, Germany. Right. So, and we are very happy. I think I can also speak for Edith that you are coming every year with, yeah. To teach us.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. This year it was a special topic, so addiction and shiatsu. Mm-hmm. Who was bringing up the idea to have this topic in this seminar? So,
Most of the times we speak about and discuss several topics. Yeah. What you think about next year? And we get a feeling of what's in the air, mm-hmm. what's needed. Mm-hmm. And this time it was addiction, mm-hmm. especially being situated in Kreuzberg, exactly. close to Cottbusser Tor. Mm-hmm. Actually, it was you, Pamela, that made me more aware of the situation, because once you live here, you get so used to it. You see the drug addicted people around the streets all day long. Mm. But you come from outside and you said, well, look at this, and you know, we should do something about it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And plus that, the clients bring the topics, and the students, of course, mm-hmm. they ask. And it looks like it's an interesting subject at the moment, right? Mm-hmm. At the moment.
Do you think it's increasing? The topic addiction or dependency is increasing after time, or compared with other years and the last
I think
years?
It's getting very different. I think there's more varieties of addiction, because we're now talking about internet addiction, porn addiction, addiction with the kids to texting and sexting, and there are all these new types of addictions that have come in with the internet age that we weren't addressing 10, 15 years ago.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, is addiction increasing? I think the types of addiction are increasing right across the common denominator.
Yeah.
I think with the economy going down, certain types of very expensive addictions, the really expensive drugs and so on, that is decreasing, but other forms of addiction are increasing.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you have to look at the entire spectrum.
Yeah. So it's not, if we are thinking, or if I was thinking as a student about, okay, addiction, I was thinking, okay, at first in your mind is getting up the idea of substances, so drugs like ecstasy, heroin, cocaine, alcohol, nicotine, all these things. But it's very interesting. If you are getting deeper in this topic, so you find so many things and behaviors and habits, mobile communication. Everyone is on his mobile phone. Mm-hmm. and being want to be online and texting, mm-hmm. as you told us.
Right.
Maybe we could have a short brainstorming.
I think the important thing is to be very aware that of the effect on the youth, on school kids now, with this constant texting and constant cell phoning, because this is stimulating an addictive type of behavior that should be very worrying to parents, and also internet addiction. There are a lot of families now restrict the number of hours every day that they allow their kids to be on the computer, and they find there's more family discussions, there are longer meals, and more family games played in the household, and definitely more reading. But that's only when the parents call these limits and don't let the kids have computers in their rooms as well. And I think one has to take those kind of measures. Very, very important, because it can stimulate future addictive behavior that will spill over into substance abuse and other forms of abuse, other forms of addiction.
And what I think what also has changed is that people became more aware of the danger of addiction, of certain things. It was different a few years ago.
Right.
You know, I remember when you came from the States, and you were surprised that we are allowed to smoke in the bars. And, you know, you always encouraged us to walk to the people, to the owners, and ask for a non-smoking area.
Exactly.
So during our lunchtime, during the weekend courses, we went to don't call names and asked, is there a section without where no smokers are allowed? Because imagine after lunch we walked back to the class and we all were smelling like a like in a Wirtschaft all together.
Exactly.
So the awareness changed a lot,
and
I'm
true.
Very, very glad about this. And with a workshop like that, we will do our part to it, to make other people more aware of it, to make our students aware of it, and then they feel encouraged to talk to their clients. Ask questions and to feel just to feel that you are allowed to ask questions and to talk about it, and that's what we practice, to talk about it.
And I was also I was a student in your workshop and last weekend, and it was a great experience that we start with little groups and to ask ourselves, what do I have some experiences by myself with this topic? So, and I could find out after the whole weekend that there are so many things that I didn't really was aware of it.
I think it's important for all of our students and also even the graduates of the program to realize that in their clinical practice they will encounter people with varieties of addictive behaviors. It might not be very obvious. They may not come in with their eyes crossed from heroin or cocaine or something, but they'll have other forms of addiction. And to give them the awareness of how to recognize it and how to address this with a particular person regarding the addictive behavior. But certainly I would probably say that all my colleagues in clinical practice have at some time or another encountered an addictive behavior in patients. It's very common, or in their own families or among their friends. So and I don't think there was one person in the room during the workshop of 30 people who was totally separate from the problem. They either had a parent or a relative or a patient or a friend or something, or knew about this very, very common problem. And it's important to recognize it and to learn from their real life experiences.
And being a practitioner, we have to look at ourselves.
Exactly.
And to deal with our parts of addiction. To recognize and to work on it, to overcome it. It's very, very important, because then we are a big help to other people.
Exactly.
Not when we are just go along with our own addictions.
Exactly.
Because that means we accept it, and we accept it on our other people as well.
Right.
But
and we
being
have that
in the process,
knowledge.
That's important. No one is holy.
Right.
But we have to be aware of it and talk about it.
Right, exactly.